Today, we embark on a journey to uncover the history of Tameshigiri, a practice that has its roots deep in Japan's past. From the remarkable blades, celebrated for their astounding sharpness, to the art of test cutting, to the fascinating tale of a family whose legacy revolved around using the bodies of criminals for these tests, we delve into a captivating history that spans centuries. The Japanese sword, an iconic creation born from Japan's unique swordsmithing techniques, represents a collective term for various bladed weapons. Its defining features include a curved blade and a single cutting edge on one side. Emerging around the late Heian period, swords with these distinctive characteristics came to be known as Japanese swords. In ancient Japan, a practice known as tameshigiri, or test cutting, was carried out to assess the sharpness of swords. Literally, translating to cutting tests, tameshigiri involved physically slicing through objects to gauge the blade's effectiveness. Each Japanese sword is a meticulously handcrafted piece, and even the most skilled swordsmith couldn't determine a sword's performance until it was put to the test. It's said that sometimes a sword that appeared exceptional would fail to deliver when it truly mattered. To avoid such a scenario in critical situations, the necessity arose to conduct test cuts to confirm a sword's capabilities. In a rather grim historical context, the practice of tameshigiri involved the use of the human body as a testing medium. This took place during the Warring States period, characterized by frequent battles and a readily available supply of corpses due to famine, disease, and conflicts. Even in the early Edo period, remnants of this martial atmosphere persisted, and samurai would occasionally use living individuals to carry out test cuts for their swords. This particular variant was known as ikidameshi, or living target tests. These living tests often involved individuals who had been condemned to death. During the early Edo period, tameshigiri reached its zenith, causing challenges in sourcing corpses. Samurai would appeal to execution grounds for priority access to bodies, or even go as far as retrieving unidentified corpses from riverbanks for testing purposes. Notably, these practices weren't limited to samurai. Public tameshigiri events drew large crowds eager to witness bodies being cleaved into pieces. However, the gruesome nature of live human testing, which sometimes involved probing the severed body parts to assess bone cuts, gradually fell out of favor as society transitioned to a more peaceful era. The practice of suemonogiri, cutting of inanimate targets, also met with resistance as times changed, eventually leading to a decline in public displays. During his stay in Japan, the missionary Louis Freus reported a remarkable cultural difference regarding sword testing. In Europe, animals were often used for this purpose, while the Japanese exclusively relied on human bodies for tameshigiri, the practice of test cutting. Ethical considerations aside, since the battlefield involved human combatants, it made rational sense for the Japanese to test their swords on human bodies. The method of tameshigiri focused on using the torso of males aged around 30 to 50. The swordsmen aimed to strike a target located slightly above the nipple, known as chichiwari, a resilient area. The goal was to deliver 10 strikes, evaluating the sword's performance. The highest rank, Saijo o Wazamono, required achieving 8 to 9 complete or near complete cuts out of 10. The o Wazamono rank was rewarded for 7 to 8 successful cuts, while Yoki Wazamono denoted 5 to 7 complete or near complete cuts. Lastly, Wazamono represented swords that managed 3 to 4 successful cuts out of 10. A critical concept emerges, the classification of a sword as wazamono, a sword with exceptional cutting ability. The evaluation of a sword's sharpness hinged on this distinction. This term was coined by Yamada Asaemon, a sword tester employed by the Edo shogunate, who selected swords for their sharpness. These swords, along with the names of master swordsmiths, were recorded in works like the Kaiho Kenjaku and the Kokon Kajibiko. Wazamono swords were further categorized into four ranks: Saijo o Wazamono, O Wazamono, Yoki Wazamono, and Wazamono, indicating their cutting prowess. Over 100 swordsmiths had their creations assessed through Tameshigiri. Furthermore, there was another method of assessment involving the use of a platform called Dodan, onto which the hands of a human body were raised and fixed. The swordsmen would then proceed to make cuts, stacking one, two, or even three bodies to evaluate the sword's performance. If one body was successfully cut through, it was termed hitotsudo, one body. If two bodies were cleaved, it became futatsudo, two bodies. These evaluations were precisely inscribed onto the tang of the blade using a technique called kinzogan, gold inlay, forming what was known as a saidanme, an engraving of the number of bodies the sword could cut through. In the context of Tameshigiri, there were instances of competitions to see how many bodies could be cleaved in a single strike. Recorded evidence indicates that records of achieving around nanatsudo, seven bodies, have been preserved as historical facts. From the astonishing sharpness demonstrated in test cutting, there are Japanese swords that carry names inspired by these feats. One such blade is known as Ichinodou Shichido, a creation of the swordsmith Muramasa from Ise Province. This sword was renowned for its extraordinary cutting ability. It belonged to the warlord Toyotomi Hidenaga, who was known as the nephew of Toyotomi Hideyoshi. Hidenaga was designated by Hideyoshi, who lacked a biological heir, as the potential next ruler, and he assumed the role of Kanpaku, or chief advisor to the emperor. It's documented in the writings of the missionary Luis Frois that Hidenaga practiced the art known as Ikido, involving live test cutting on condemned prisoners. This practice of test cutting required considerable skill, suggesting Hidenaga's proficiency in swordsmanship and his commitment to martial values, even as a high-ranking figure. The name of this sword is inscribed on the tang of the sword. This name derives from Hidenaga's remarkable feat of successfully cutting through the same spot, referred to as Ichinodou, on a human body seven times. Unlike titles like Futatsudou, two bodies, which indicate cutting through multiple bodies in a single strike, Ichinodou Shichido commemorates the astonishing sharpness of the blade through its ability to sever a challenging area, the rib-rich region of the torso, seven times. This demonstrated its exceptional cutting capability. It's worth noting that Muramasa's blades later became associated with legends of cursed swords, though this perception largely emerged after the death of Tokugawa Ieyasu. During the time of their creation, Muramasa's swords were recognized as exceptional swords without any particular anomaly. During the Edo period, there existed clans that held the responsibility of being test cutters for swords. As the Edo period progressed and an era of peace, the brutality of test cutting began to be shunned. Additionally, a significant portion of society was comprised of samurai who had never taken a life. In response, specialized positions for test cutting were established. The Yamada Asaemon family is notable in this context. They held the hereditary position of Otameshi Goyo, specializing in test cutting during the Edo period. They were also executioners, earning the nicknames Kubikiri Asaemon, which means Asaemon the Beheader. Their test-cutting technique was known as Suemono, and although it was viewed with a degree of aversion, it was an honorable pursuit within the realm of the samurai. The sharpness of a Japanese sword is determined not only by the skill of the person performing the test cutting, but also by the ability of the swordsmith who forged the blade. The fifth generation Yamada Asaemon possessed the skill to perform Tsuri-do, a technique within the art of Shitojutsu that involves severing a corpse. This was accomplished by suspending the body of a criminal executed by hanging from the tip of an inclined log, then striking the body to cut it in half horizontally. Unlike conventional test cutting, where the body is fixed to the ground, this technique was extremely challenging. If not executed swiftly after drawing the sword, the suspended body would sway, impeding a clean cut. Additionally, if the blade did not make a perpendicular contact with the body, the cutting trajectory would curve, resulting in an unsuccessful cut. Yamada Asaemon possessed exceptional expertise in this form of test cutting. Although a Ronin, the Yamada Asaemon family was prosperous. They engaged in various business endeavors using the severed bodies. Since they were given the rights to the executed body, they received organs from daimyos and wealthy merchants to produce medicinal treatments. This lucrative business brought significant wealth to the Yamada family. Additionally, they earned income by appraising swords requested by daimyos, feudal lords, and wealthy sword enthusiasts. However, they were generous with their wealth, dedicating it extensively to the commemoration of the deceased. The Shōunji Temple in Tokyo still has the monument called Motodori-zuka, erected by the sixth generation of Yamada Asaemon. They also learned haiku poetry to understand the last words of condemned prisoners and to fulfill their duties with respect. In the post-Edo era, the Yamada Asaemon family continued to carry out execution duties for the Meiji government. For a time after the Meiji Restoration, they persisted as executioners. However, as the method of execution shifted to hanging and the sale of human organs became prohibited by law, their sources of income dwindled and the lineage eventually faded away. The last Yamada Asaemon passed away in 1911. In closing, the history of Tameshigiri, the art of test cutting with Japanese swords, is a fascinating journey through time. From its origins in ancient Japan to its evolution during the samurai era, Tameshigiri has not only showcased the exceptional sharpness of Japanese swords, but also reflected the cultural and ethical values of the time. Today, Tameshigiri lives on as a martial art and a way to preserve the traditions of the past. Modern practitioners, both in Japan and around the world, continue to use this art form to test their skills and to keep the legacy of the Japanese sword alive. We hope you enjoyed this exploration into the world of Japanese swords. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more exciting content about the history of Japanese swords. Until next time, sayonara.